中部篇，在中国的心脏地带，会有哪些你所不知道的精彩正在上演？
China is changing. In the last 10 years, it's seen the most extraordinary transformation in every aspect of modern life. Its economy, its technology, its transport, and its culture.
In this series, we'll be exploring one of the most varied and surprising countries in the world. From the remote mountains and diversity of the southwest
to the frozen lands of the northeast, huge deserts to teeming cities.
We'll see how people all over China are facing the challenges of the future whilst preserving the traditions of their past.
Welcome to Tales from Modern China.
In this program, we're journeying to the very heart of central China and uncovering the cultural crossroads in the nation's capital. Jason joins the high rollers at China's biggest auction.
And this has just shot up in value.
Cameron feels the speed on the fastest rail network in the world. And I'm going back in time in Beijing in search of some classic Chinese design.
Beijing. A city with over 3,000 years of history and the imperial center of successive dynasties. A city at the forefront of the nation's rapid modernization. But as spending power has rocketed here over the last decade, Chinese people are discovering a renewed interest in their past culture and heritage.
And that is why, even though China's only recently opened its doors to foreign auction houses, it's already the largest art market in the world. And today, six of the world's top 10 auction houses are Chinese.
One of the biggest of these is China Guardian Auctions, who recently sold an ancient manuscript for a record-breaking $30 million. Here, the final day's viewing is underway for one of their biggest sales of the year. Over the next 5 days, four auction rooms will be running almost continuously from 10 a.m. till midnight. They will sell 6,000 lots in 280 hours of auctioneering. As you'd expect, much of what they're selling is traditional Chinese art and artifacts, paintings, porcelain, ceramics, and calligraphy. Mrs. Hu Yanyan, China Guardian CEO, shows me one of the star lots in this treasure trove. A huge Qing Dynasty porcelain vase.
Why is this piece so important?
It's because it's a Qing Dynasty porcelain. It's a Qing Dynasty porcelain vase.
Yeah, the water, look, you can actually feel the water. It's really quite stunning. So which one do you like?
This one is my favorite piece because I collect single-use.
Antiques enthusiast Miss Feng Weiyu has traveled nearly 2,000 kilometers to be here. During the preview, buyers are allowed to carefully examine the lots to check their condition. And for Miss Feng, only the best will do.
You can use light to see. You can see that this glass is very thin. 它会有一点点的一个，这个地方是有个小的一个痕迹，对对对，你可以看到吗？小的是因为瓷器呢嘛，所以这个品相要求很重要。我的要求就是要品相完美的。Put
off by this almost invisible flaw, the bowl drops down Miss Feng's shopping list. What really catches her eye is the Emperor's faultless vase.
你看这一件是乾隆的双耳，那个窑变釉的双耳瓶啊，这颜色非常漂亮，流光溢彩啊！你看。
Can I come and watch you when you bid?
好啊，好啊，欢迎啊，欢迎。
While many of these beautiful objects are hundreds of years old, the auction house itself, founded in 1993, is still relatively new. Xu Jun is Beijing's most experienced auctioneer.
那个我从事这个行业呢有18年了，那么开始呢拍这种小的拍品，那么单件油品我们才1-2千块钱，那么现在呢由于18年了，那么到了现在呢已经可以单件拍品呢已经拍到好几个亿了。
The auction is a magnet for connoisseurs from across China, and I've been invited by avid collector Miss Feng to watch her bid for her vase. This 5-day auction starts with a bang, the highest price lots all up for sale on the first night. Soon, the sumptuous Qing vase that I saw earlier goes under the hammer.
Done. $1.5 million for this beautiful vase. That's a bargain, I think.
Finally, it's time for the lot that Miss Feng has set her sights on.
今天晚上应该会拍得很好，我有点担心，不知道能不能拍得到。
2613号起交价18万、18万、18万、19万、19万、20万、22万。
刚开始的时候我就等一等，因为刚开始是很多支牌，然后等他，你看又来一个。
So she's gonna wait a bit.
35万。
$53,000.
38万。
It's really very exciting. And it looks like two people, Miss Feng and someone else, who desperately want this beautiful vase. I wonder how far she's gonna go.
42万、42万、43万、48万、50万、52万、55万。
This was just shot up in value on its original price.And she's keeping going. We're on $88,000 now, still climbing.
61万，还有加价的吗？61万，61万，最后一次。
The gavel's about to go down. Has she got it?
8203号。
非常开心。
By the end of the evening, nearly $100 million is gone under Mr. Su's hammer in just one day.
今天我在台上已经这个台上已经站了7.5小时，所以说呢，也是对我来说，真是体力、意志都是一种考验。我对我来说，可能最大的愿望就是现在就是回去睡觉了、休息了，明天还要工作。
I can really tell by the way that you're touching it that you really love this piece.
是的，非常的喜欢，应该说是找到我心爱的东西，非常的美。你看几百年留存下来，它还那么完整，所以我也要好好的保管它。
On Earth, and it's becoming more mobile by the day. One of the biggest changes is China's flagship high-speed train network, the longest of its kind in the world. In 2015, it carried 961 million passengers. And there's one man who has seen more of China's railway network than just about anyone else. Railway photographer and all-round train enthusiast Wang Wei.
我从小就住在铁道边上，我呢就是与生俱来的喜欢火车，就是与生俱来的。对于我来说，最爱做的事情应该就是这个拍摄火车，它就确实就特别美。
Aged just 26, Wang Wei's photos have already caught the attention of the Chinese government's Department for Railways. I'm meeting him for his latest assignment. We're heading off from Beijing West Station to photograph the trains in Zhengzhou, the capital of Henan Province. And immediately, they've got a surprise for him.
We're going in.
With safety the priority, especially in foggy weather, today's driver is focused on the job. So we're being shown around by his colleague, Mr. Song.
首先啊，我想问一下，开这样的一个火车是什么感觉呢？
这种感觉非常非常非常的爽。开高铁动车组就像飞了一样，每小时310公里的速度，一个人坐在驾驶室里，有一种驾驭感。
By 2025, there'll be nearly enough Chinese high-speed railway to travel around the equator.
晚了，你肯定很了解啊。 你开了多少公里？
我大概开了有300多万公里。哇，
你为什么做这样的一个工作呢？
我的爷爷、我的父亲都在铁路上工作。小时候我的志向就是看着飞驰而过的火车，我心里默默地想，长大以后我也一定要开火车。
Here we are at Zhengzhou Station.
That was fast.
Zhengzhou East Station is the central crossroads of the network and the country's largest high-speed railway hub. It used to take 12 hours to get from Beijing to Zhengzhou. Now the journey takes just 2.5. And one man who's seen the transformation of Zhengzhou East Station is train driver Mr. Song's father, who also spent his life working on the railway.
你好，
我才40多有的时间，我上到火车上，看见司机，他们甜美嘛，整齐齐，哎，甜美，烧水，整齐齐。
那时候干活可累啊，
哎，对，那时候可辛苦啊。
对呀、啊，
哎，司机。
我觉得这个很难得啊，就是有两代都在啊，他可以给你们拍照吗？你是不是也要记录一下？
可以。
那个漂亮，特别好。
拜拜。
65,000 passengers use Zhengzhou East Station every day, so it's crucial that things run smoothly. So next on Wang Wei's photographic shopping list is the place where this massive operation is controlled.
你好。
Wu Haoshu helps to keep the system running on time, monitoring up to 300 trains every day.
就比如一天就是晚点3趟车的话，都会觉得不太顺利。今天
等一下，你的意思是如果1%的车延迟了，这不好？
对，因为高铁就是要安全正点嘛。
With such a punctual service, getting Wang Wei's final shot shouldn't be too difficult.
We've come to Hebei Station, just one stop out of Zhengzhou, to really get the experience of one of these monsters flying by at full throttle. There's one due down the track any minute now. Here it comes. Now that was fast.
Coming up next on Tales from Modern China, Jin goes on a fashion spree.And I brush up on my handwriting.
寻常的讲述，中英联合摄制，全流程深度合作。这是一次激动人心的体验，用国际化视角解读中国传奇。
中国这么大，永远都不晚。
跟我一起发现
你所不知道的中国。
6月3日起，江苏广电总台、英国广播公司视觉盛宴同步引爆。
The central region is dominated by the capital Beijing, trendsetter for the nation. It's the home of glitzy, glamorous Chinese Fashion Week, and China's fashionistas are keen to buy.
As China's opened up in the last few decades, the uniform clothing in shops has been replaced by a globally recognizable wardrobe.
三里屯里面那个 COS。Basic House 啊
，HF 啊，
这民族好像有点夸张。
There isn't a distinctive Chinese style to people's clothing. We could be anywhere in the world. That's globalization for you.
Nowadays, the whole world seems to wear just a handful of brands.
But it hasn't always been this way.Back in the 1920s, a new innovation, the movies, meant that traditional Chinese styles came under the influence of Western fashions.
Inspired by the latest fashions from Paris, the traditional loose-fit costumes of the Qing Dynasty were updated and made popular by the cinema. A new dress style was born. It was called the qipao. While its high collars and simple lines look unmistakably Chinese to us today, the qipao is in fact a fusion of Western style with Chinese tradition, and was a staple of the glamorous fashion scene back in the first golden age of Chinese cinema.
温太太，温经理好啊，还好，气氛好。
I've come to the Beijing Institute of Fashion in search of a true guardian of the classic 1930s cheap half, Professor Shi Liping.
哎，石老师你好啊！你好，欢迎你的到来。
谢谢。哇，你们这里真漂亮，那么多旗袍，哇，这都是你们做的。
然后这件呢是跟我师父30多年前跟我师父学的时候做的第一件旗袍啊。
旗袍是什么？
某种意义上来讲，旗袍就是、这个领型的设计，
嗯哼，
再加上盘扣，然后再加上非常合体，然后再加上两边开气儿。
Traditional qipaos are simple and elegant as they are made from a single piece of material buttoned down one side of the body. While the qipao contains a westernized twist, it still preserves the essence of traditional Chinese design.
然后这个领子也是把住我们女人的脖子，过去不希望女人左顾右盼，所以是中式的理念，就是让女人内敛、含蓄、柔美而不张扬的状态啊。
Okay, so be more modest.
But has the Chinese character of classic qipao chic been lost to globalization? One young fashion designer, Shi Mingyue, is determined to bring sexed-up qipaos back onto China's catwalks.And in her honor, I'm wearing one myself.
Excited. This is our new collection.
Mm-hmm.
Like, really different.
It is very different.
Yeah.
It's quite revealing.
Like, yeah, a lot of dresses are kind of revealing.
Yeah.
We're trying to revolutionize the qipao design.
Mm.
Our customers mostly are young people in China. Like, maybe they will have a very traditional qipao for their wedding.
Yeah.
But they like qipao. They want to wear it into their everyday life.
Yeah, yeah.
I would wear this every day.
They go with boots as well.
A different qipao each day. Sometimes underwater, sometimes in midair, as she traveled the world for a year for a performance project blog before she set up her company.
I really want to break the rules of how qipao were designed. I like scuba diving. I like doing those extreme sports. We want to create option for today's Chinese girls. Like when they want to buy Chinese looking clothes, there's also an option that is like qipao. Young people have the right to wear qipao.
Shi's target market is young, independent Chinese women like herself. And for her New Year's special photo shoot, she's using her tape and girl power to sell dresses.
So why are we in a boxing ring?
Because in China, when you go home every year, you'll meet your like mother, aunts, so everyone will ask you like, oh, why are you still single? Like you should find someone to marry. So today we're saying that, oh, you should learn some boxing before going home for this kind of like, you can take some matches. Qipao was a very rebelling dress in the very beginning. So when you tie it back to the like origin of qipao, I think that kind of connected.
Wow, mm-hmm. I think you could be the future.
Thank you.
For that.
Yeah.
Clothing is not the only aspect of traditional Chinese culture that deserves appreciation. The Chinese script is one of the most complex and ancient writing systems in the world. Some say dating back over 6,000 years.But in the modern age, it's facing new challenges. There are about 90,000 Chinese characters in the modern language. Not many people master them all, but you will need to know about 1,000 just to read a newspaper. I've come to Anyang City to join a handwriting class at Yingxing South Primary School.
When I first started learning Chinese, the hardest part by far was not the speaking, but the writing. I mean, when you think about it, thousands of tiny characters, all with their own individual meanings.
But today, people's reliance on texting and typing means their relationship with writing is changing. In order to understand why, I've come to the Anyang Museum of Handwriting to meet Richard Sears, a leading researcher on Chinese characters. He came to China in the 1970s from America to study the DNA of the Chinese squids.
The most important thing to understand about Chinese characters is that they're sometimes derived from a pictograph. And if you know the original pictograph and its original meaning, all of these lines, all of these strokes suddenly are logical.
I see.
Now, this is a woman, and it's a character of a kneeling woman. And these are breasts. They may look like hands, but they're breasts. And this is a broom. And this is the handle. And this, you can see that you swipe with the broom. Women very good with brooms back in the old days.
Through the centuries, handwriting has changed. Perhaps the biggest change came in the 1950s when the government promoted using simplified versions of the characters in a drive to increase literacy rates.
Now, here there's a big transition. This woman doesn't look like this woman. This is a simplified character.
And in the modern era, our reliance on computers means the distance between these simplified characters and their original pictograph just got a little bit greater. It wouldn't be practical to have a keyboard with 90,000 individual characters, so software offered a solution using the Roman alphabet.
If I say D-A-N,
right,
we can see here a number of characters that are all pronounced Dan. One of them is the character for egg. This character is pretty easy to recognize, but it's really quite difficult to write if you don't happen to remember exactly all the strokes. If you don't remember it, you're lost.
So is the ancient skill of Chinese handwriting slowly disappearing? Handwriting teacher Song Xin tells me more.
现在科技的发展的确给我们带来了方便，但是呢，这个提笔忘字这种现象呢，的确时有发生。所以现在呢，从国家到地方都认识到了这个问题。
Government changes to the curriculum mean that now 10 minutes of every class is dedicated just to handwriting, and school calligraphy clubs and handwriting competitions are increasingly popular.There are even game shows on national TV.
铲，请开始答题。
In a Chinese version of a spelling bee, children compete live to write the most complicated characters from memory.
祝贺红方选手在这一组赛。
如果中国消失了这些文字，会是一个什么样子的情况呢？
绝对不可能。这种现象绝对不可能发生，这是文化，这是我们祖国的根，我们不能丢。汉字绝对不会消失。
下面是个口字，对的。
Next time we are in China's freezing northeast, where we uncover the prehistoric past and drive into the future.
Looks like it's been dusted with icing sugar. It's like a scene out of a fairy tale.
Design that's more young, more fashionable.
I think it could be the future.
Let's do something like that.
Yeah. This is bonkers.
Now that was fast.
I've had a way of the time. It has been so cool.
China is an incredible country, and I don't think you realize that just from reading it.
Nice, 我不知道的中国。